Hello, I'm Marta and this is 20th episode about rebuild of my DR350S. In this episode, we will start rebuilding the rear master cylinder and the rear brake caliper. I divided this video into two parts, so in this part we will disassemble and clean the rear master cylinder and the rear brake caliper. In the next part, we will assemble everything back, change the rubber brake line into stainless steel one and fit the brakes with new brake fluid. In the end, our rear brake will look like this. But we will begin with the rear brake looking like that. Let's start the disassembly with unscrewing two bolts holding brake caliper cover guard. Next, we take out two pins holding the brake pads so then we can pull them out. Now we separate the brake caliper from the bracket by sliding it out from two pins. Then we dismount the rubber boot, the retainer clip and the shaft bolt from the bracket. After that we unscrew the shaft bolt and shaft bolt rubber boot from the brake caliper. Next, we remove the piston by pressing the master cylinder a couple of times. It should come out without any problems. We discovered there is a problem with piston dust seal. Part of it was ripped apart and it was blocking the piston movement, so replacement is a must. Now we can unscrew the banjo bolt holding the brake hose. There are two crash washers per one banjo bolt that need to be replaced after any banjo bolt removal. Next, we pull out the spring pads and then we can remove the dust and piston seals. I used an old filler gauge to do this. Then we remove the brake bleeder screw and cap. Finally, the brake caliper is completely disassembled. The piston seal was looking pretty good, but as you can see, the dust seal is garbage, so we need to replace it. Let's move on to the master cylinder. We start with unscrewing the banjo bolt holding the brake hose. Again, note that there are crash washers which we need to replace. Now we squeeze and slide out the hose clamp so we can remove the hose connected to the master cylinder. We make the same thing on the second hose end, which is connected to the brake reservoir. Next, we can disassemble the reservoir into every possible part. After that, we take out the ring securing the brake reservoir connector and then the connector itself. You should find an O-ring sealing connection between the connector and the master cylinder. Now we loosen the jam nut locking the yoke so the yoke is free to unscrew. Afterwards we can take the yoke into parts. First we take out the cotter pin, then washer and in the end a pin. Getting back to the master cylinder, now we can remove its dust boot. Then we can take out the securing ring which holds the push rod. After that we can remove the push rod. Finally, we can remove the piston from the master cylinder. Then we can pull off the piston spring and then remove its two rubber caps. The primary cap is easier to remove. The secondary cup is a bit harder. I had to help myself with a ball-ended Allen wrench, but you should be careful to not damage the cup. To clean the caliper, the master cylinder and the bracket, I handed everything to David, who did glass blasting on his own. Here's how it was looking. After glass blasting, you need to thoroughly clean every glass blasted part with an engine cleaner and generously rinse everything with water. In the end, we use an air blue gun to get rid of the water and remaining glass particles. Here are the results of today's cleaning. Finally, our disassembled rear brake system looks like this. Though in this picture you can note, we added also new stainless steel brake hose and the brake caliper repair kit. We will use them in the next episode when we will put everything back together. For dessert, we have a cheat sheet with measurements of all parts needed for the rebuild for DR350S from 1993. We had problems with finding out the new fitting ones ourselves. We bought the repair kit in a local shop and it was originally fitting the Honda CB600F produced from 2007 to 2010. Hope it helps. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed, leave a like and stay tuned for the next videos documenting DR rebuilding.